All right, welcome to this webinar about studying in the Nordic countries, which will be held by me, Johan from Dream Studies, and our partner, Jürgen from Instituto Nordico. Great to have you with us. So here you can see on the top left corner, you have a Swedish flag followed by a Danish to the right, Finnish to the bottom left, and Norwegian on the bottom right. And this is, of course, the Nordic countries. And let me tell you shortly about Dream Studies. Here you can see our website from DreamStudiesAbroad.com. At Dream Studies, you find free information about studying abroad, regardless of where in the world you want to study. We have almost 100 articles, a lot of videos about studying abroad, guides. You can ask FAQ questions about studying abroad. We have a school database with schools all over the world. So a lot of free information you can use there. And we can help you to find schools abroad. Almost all over the world. And we can offer partial scholarships and discounts to our partner schools, schools which we are directly in contact with. Not so many of them in Scandinavia, unfortunately, but we can offer scholarships for IBA in Kolding in Denmark. And our help is always risk-free. You never pay us anything. It's free of charge. You pay directly to the schools because, unfortunately, most schools abroad have a tuition fee, with the exception of schools in the Nordic countries if you happen to be an EU student. And if you want more help from us at Dream Studies, you just fill out our information request form at DreamStudiesAbroad.com. And if you're interested in studying in the Nordic countries, and then you will get more information now from our partner, Instituto Nordico. Take it away, Jürgen.
Well, thank you, Johan, for the introduction. I know that not too many here on the webinar today, but this is getting recorded, as you can see, and it will be uploaded to YouTube. So now I'm going to make a short presentation about us, and I was going to tell a bit more about what it's like to study in the Nordics, among other things. So the first thing people think about when they see, when they think about the Nordics, it probably might be like the Northern Light, something I see. It says here in Spanish, Aurora Borealis, because that's where we are based. We are based in Bogota, Colombia. It's quite far away from some of you guys, but it's not really a problem. We're more than happy to help you online wherever you need. We can organize it like a meeting on Zoom or something. That's not a problem. So basically, my name is Jürgen Sjöberg. I am the founder of Instituto Nordico, a company I founded back in 2007 and represent quite a few universities in the Nordic countries. And something quite interesting about the Nordics countries that a lot of people can't put on the map. So here you can see them. So they got here Norway, Sweden, Finland, and Denmark are the Nordic countries, and also Iceland. We also work for the university in UK, which is called Queen's University in Belfast. That's another one we work with. So here you can put that, because here on the maps, these are the Nordic countries and then Iceland, but we don't work with the university in Iceland. One thing which is quite important in the Nordic countries is the sustainable development goals. And as you can see, no poverty, recycling and everything, and it's another thing. If you look, so Johan, looking at these things, have you got any experience of those ones? Looking at living in Sweden?
Yeah, quite a lot. I had to unmute myself there. But yeah, definitely many of these describe life in Sweden, which is quite... I think in some ways it's one of the safer countries on earth. Just we have really this, you know, social safety. So we don't have the poverty. We have the free healthcare. We have the free education for Swedish and EU citizens. And it's not maybe as disastrous if you lose your job in Sweden as if you would do it in another country like the US or something where everything kind of depends on it. So it is a quite pleasant country to live in that way.
And the other, you know, something very interesting here, looking at it, sustainable development goals, it's Finland first, Denmark in the third place, Sweden on the fourth place, and Norway on the fourth place. Quite interesting. They're pretty much like top, very much like top on these rankings. Finland, Denmark, Sweden, Norway. Quite interesting. Yeah. Another thing that's quite interesting, looking at the Global Innovation Index, is that Switzerland, that a lot of people confuse Sweden with Switzerland, is the ranked at the top one, looking at the Global Innovation Index, but Sweden is on the third place, and US is on the second place. Quite interesting. Sweden is on the second place, looking at Global Innovation Index. A lot of people sort of think, well, which companies are from Sweden? Well, there are quite a few ones. And in general, from the Nordic countries, as you can see here, like I can imagine, like some of you probably got an H&M store in the country, even perhaps like an IKEA, which is a very big on furniture. Tetra Pak is another one. Pretty much most of the liquid, looking at milk, are packed in a Tetra Pak. And then Volvo. Might have seen some Volvo cars in your home country, which are also from Sweden. Lego is from Denmark. Spotify is a Swedish invention. Fjällräven, perhaps you have seen them, very, very interesting bags. Something a lot of people ask, well, why did Nordic countries need professionals like you? Well, I think the most interesting thing here is that, aging as got a very aging population, so we need a lot of professionals because a lot of people get retired, so we need a lot of professionals. We also like people that are very innovative. As you could see here, quite a few companies are from Sweden, and a lot of startups. It's quite easy to open up a business in Sweden. And people like people that are very innovative, and they also invest a lot of innovation. We also very much looking at pioneers in renewable energy. For example, they need in the northern parts of Sweden, in a town called Luleå, they need 5,000 people for their battery factory they're constructing at the moment. They need quite a lot of people in renewable energy. Another thing is, as I said, we need a lot of professionals. That's also quite interesting because in the Nordic countries, some people perhaps don't feel like, when they finish their undergraduate studies, they don't feel, why should I go for a master's studies if I already got a job? So most of the master programs in the Nordic countries are actually in English. So we can offer you free consulting to study at the university you can see here. Chalmers is a very good university looking engineering. And I'd say about 99% of the ones who study at Chalmers find a job actually afterward. 99% find a job, quite good employability rate. Another one here is Uppsala University, it's a very good university. About 9 of their alumni have won the Nobel Prize. Aalto is another good university, which is very good at design. And another one I really like here is EIT Invenity, who has got double degrees in renewable energy programs. So you can start, for example, 1 year at Politecnico Torino, and then another year at KTH in Sweden or Uppsala. Among other ones, so pretty much like top universities where you can do like a double degree programs. Another good thing about EIT in energy is that the tuition fee also covers traveling costs and also accommodation if you like to participate at certain conferences, and all these things are included in the program fee. Another one here is SDU that we're going to have a look at in a short while. So when it comes to studying in Finland, a lot of people ask about scholarships. I think that is the most common question from a lot of people. So Finland got a scholarship that covers the entire tuition fee and also 5,000 for living costs for the first year of studies. So what's going to happen if it's a program which is 2 years? What can you do in the second year? Well, apply for a scholarship from the university. Most of the universities got scholarships that covers the entire tuition fee. So about 100% of the tuition fee will be covered. after the second year, after the first year, looking at the university work with. So we work here with Hankin, Aalto, and Lund University are the ones you can apply to. We'd like to apply for this study in Finland scholarship. Another one, very good scholarship is the one that Swedish Institute offers. It's not for all nationals, it's about 42 nationals that can apply for this scholarship. But please contact us if you're interested in studying in Sweden, then we can have a look at if you can apply for this scholarship. And this one is covered pretty much for every all universities in Sweden. And the ones we work with here is like Chalmers, Uppsala, Jönköping, Linnaeus, University of West, and University of Skövde. And as you can see, it's a very generous one. It covers the entire tuition fee, furthermore, 1,100 euros for monthly for living, and also the tickets to Sweden. So it's a very, very generous scholarship. And I think it's probably one of the best ones actually in the world, because it covers everything pretty much. And as I told you, like EIT Energy is an organization that is co-funded by the European Union. And what's interesting with them is that their tuition, the tuition fee covers also the conferences. So you can even go with like three different conferences, up to the three different conferences per semester. So you'll be in contact with the industry from the very, very first day. And looking at the employability rate here, it's very, very high. I think about 94% find a job in 6 months after they finish their studies, and about 84% actually stay and work in Europe. And as I said, like you got a battery factory up in the northern part of Sweden, and they need 5,000 people at the moment. They haven't got them yet. So yeah, the employability possibilities there are huge, in particular in renewable energy. They got some scholarships. It's not that easy to get them, but they got a scholarship that covers 100% and also one that covers 50% of the tuition fee. But I would say this is everything's about an investment here, because the possibility to find a job are very, very high. Another university to work with, which is a very, very good one, is SDU, which is in the southern parts of Denmark. And they got a scholarship that covers 100% of their tuition fee. Furthermore, 400 euros monthly for the living cost. What is very interesting with them, as you can see here, is that they got the guaranteed job, actually. So when they finish the study, they're going to get a guaranteed job, and it pay quite well. They pay about 5,000 euros if you haven't got that much experience, but it might be much, much more to get a guaranteed job. And this one is for ones who are electronic engineers or mechatronic engineers. Then they got a guaranteed job here. And what you need, yeah, you need to reach a B1 level in Danish. And it's not that, I would say, that difficult. And actually, the courses in Danish are for free as well. And a lot of people actually find a job before they even finish their studies. There's another very interesting option. I'm looking at what you need. Want to study in the Nordic countries. Well, most universities, they ask for an IELTS about 6.5 and no band score below 5.5. But it depends a little bit. It might be a little bit more looking at the band score, but in the end, 6.5, no band score below 5.5. Look at the TOEFL, you need between 88 and 92 and minimum writing 20. Something that is very, very important looking at studying in the Nordic countries is the prerequisites for certain programs. So it might be the case that, you need about 15 credits in mathematics, you need 15 credits in physics to be able to apply for the programs and to get accepted. And that is something that can help you as well, looking at the prerequisites for the programs you'll get accepted. And a lot of people ask about these things, that can I work while I'm studying? Yes, you can. Looking at in Sweden, unlimited hours, Finland, 30 hours per week, Norway, 20 hours, and well, Denmark, 20 hours per week. And it's unlimited during the vacational time in the Nordics. And how long can I stay when I finish the studies? This is a bit quite interesting, because a lot of countries say, well, hey, you can stay here and you can work for 2 years, while in the Nordic countries, it's a little bit different. It's pretty much like you see it in Sweden, you can stay for 1 year to look for a job. And then when you got the job, then you change a visa to work visa. In Norway, it's 6 months. But what we have seen is that a lot of people find a job actually before they even finish their studies. And in Denmark, it's 3 years to find a job. And as you can see, SAU actually guarantee you a job. So pretty much what happens is that you get a job and then you change it to work visa. Then you can stay for as long as the contract lasts. And a lot of people actually stay quite a few years in the Nordics, and they become permanent residents. And then after they apply for a passport, actually. So it's quite good opportunities here. And looking at how much it is to study in the Nordic countries, well, it depends a bit on the programs. I would say in humanities, it's a bit lower than in engineering. So in Sweden, it's between 5,000 and 7,000 per semester. And the living cost is about 850 euros. And I would say, like, looking, if you compare this with perhaps some other countries, it's not that high, actually. And looking here at Finland, the tuition fee has been 3,700 and 7,500 euros. And the living cost is about 600 euros, which I think is quite a good value. What happens here with Finland is that they get, the students got a lot of discounts. For example, having a lunch for a student in Finland is about 3 euros. 3 euros, I would say, if you compare it with a lot of countries, 3 euros is not that much. Norway might be a bit more expensive, but the semester fee at the university we work with, which is BI, is about 5,500 euros per semester. But what we have seen with BI is that a lot of people actually find a job on the first semester, and their programs are 4 semesters, and they find a job at the first semester. And then looking at Denmark, yeah, the semester fee is about 7,000 euros. But what is interesting is that, yeah, pretty much they guaranteed a job when you finished your studies. And the living cost is about 900 euros a month. And I said, yeah, it's quite some money, but yeah, you can work while you're studying. Although you can work while you're studying, I think it's very important to keep in mind that you need to focus on your studies and while you are in the Nordics. And sometimes it might be tricky to work while you're studying because the workload looking at the master's is quite high, actually. But yeah, you can work while you're studying. And a lot of people actually find a job in English, although looking at Sweden, when in Sweden we speak Swedish, in Finland we speak Finnish, in Norway we speak Norwegian, then Denmark they speak Denmark. Looking at the English knowledge in the Nordics is probably one of the highest ones in the world, actually. I'm not sure on which place Sweden is at the moment. It's like the fourth place in the world, looking at the best, having the best English level. But yeah, it's very, very high. Most people have a very, very good English level. So you can work in English in all countries. But as I mentioned, I think it's very important to focus on your studies. Most of the universities offer partial or 100% scholarship on tuition fee, and this depends on your GPA. But I think the most important thing here is to look at studies as an investment. So how will you fund your studies if you don't get a scholarship? This is a very, very good question. It's in blank here. But the reason is that we work a lot with the South American students, and I think it's very important to look at how you can find your status if you're not, if you don't get a scholarship. And I think there might be like you get a bank loan, perhaps there are some governmental loans you can apply for. So I will leave it for you to have a look at. If you don't get a scholarship, how are you going to find your studies? Because being accepted, for example, to Uppsala is quite tricky. And you get accepted, but then how are you going to find your studies if you don't get a scholarship? I think that is something you need to have a look at, because it's not that easy to get accepted. Looking at us, well, Instituto Nordico, we are based in Bogota, Colombia. But we've got our own fair called Expo Nordico, which is a hybrid fair. And last year, about 1,500 people signed up for the fair we had. So we got even people like from Africa, people from Asia participating in the fair. And the fair itself is for free. Which services do Instituto Nordico offer? Well, all our services are for free. Looking at finding a program according to your profile, we can also help you with a motivation letter that doesn't cost anything either. We can also help you with a visa application a little bit. So yeah, motivation letter, finding programs according to your profile, and help you with a visa is for free. If you like to study Swedish or Norwegian or Finnish with us, yeah, well, those courses cost some money, but they are on, we do them online. So it doesn't matter if you are in Asia or somewhere else, yeah, you can still do them with us. We also have a Swedish exam center, so you can present, you can do the Swedish exam with us. And we also got preparation courses for the IELTS exam. If you want to prepare for that exam, we got a course for that one. And as I said, free consultation if we can help you with applying for the programs without any cost. Looking at applying for to Finland, to University of Finland, it's for free. To apply for a program in Sweden, I think it's about 90 euros. To study in Norway at BI, does cost anything. Denmark, I think, about 90 euros. And we've also got an official translator here in Colombia, but it might be free to find an official translator in your own country. And please follow us on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. I know there were some questions here. You asked some questions when you sign up for this webinar, so I got to have a look at them now. Here's one about, I want to do a master in journalism in Finland, how much reduction you can give. Well, it depends a little bit. As I said, there's a scholarship in Finland that covers the entire tuition fee. There's some scholarships. It might be up to 100%, and also 5,000 for living costs the first year. Another question was about job availability after graduation. There were a lot of possibilities here. I think depending on what you like to study, but for example, in engineering, the employability rate is very, very high. It's all looking at Chalmers, they say like 99% of our students find a job in 6 months after they have started, finished their studies. But it depends a lot on what you have studied. But I would say most people find a job in Sweden. It might not be the dream job they find at first, but I would say like if you like to stay in the Nordics, there are a lot of, you can stay, I would say. But it might be not be that you find your dream job from very, very beginning. Here's a question about electrical and mechanical engineering. Yes, there are quite a few programs in engineering. So please contact us and we can have a look at it, which programs are best, that best suits to your profile, looking at modern electrical and mechanical engineering. Looking at the cost, studying in the Nordics, looking at a program in humanities, it's about 5,000 euros. Looking at a program in engineering, is about 7,000 euros per semester. Some more questions. How about finance? Looking at the scholarships, they're merit-based, most of the scholarships, but looking at the one in Sweden, is they not merit-based? You need to do a good motivation letter of why you should receive this scholarship. So depending on each scholarship. Can you apply for scholarships if you're from the EU? Well, I would say it's a good question because most of the programs in the EU are for free if you're from the if you got a European passport. But that is not the case with BI in Norway. In Norway, BA in Norway, they charge for everybody. And even people from Norway need to pay the tuition fee to be able to study at BI. BI is an amazing university. It's pretty much like, a lot of people find a job the first semester. And it's not like working at a cafeteria. It's about working at companies like Yara. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Yara, but it's one of the biggest companies in Norway and most well-known in the world. So that's a very good option. If you like to study in order to study at BI, everybody needs to pay to study at BI. And looking at bachelor, I especially wish to apply for bachelor degree in Denmark. Yes, we work with, looking at bachelor degree in Denmark, we work with SDU, which is close to the border with Germany. They got bachelor degrees in Denmark. Everything depends a bit on what you're looking for here in which I would like to do a bachelor degree. Can I see here?
Also got a question in the chat there.
Yeah. Do you offer help for students that already got admitted to a program on a Nordic country? Yes, I think we can help you out. It depends a little bit on which university you've been admitted to. So please, Ines, send us a message. Send it to, you can send directly to us. Send it to an email to Johan, and then we can have a look at it. It was quite a very fast presentation about studying in the Nordics. But Johan, what do you think about all these opportunities that the Nordic countries can offer to foreigners?
I think the Nordics really have a lot to offer to international students. I mean, as I said, it's safe countries, students really speak good English, and nature is really just around the corner. So as long as you don't mind some cold winters and things like that, I think the Nordics is a great place to study. And also the distances in Europe are not so long. So while you're here, you can also explore other Nordic countries just through the weekend or whatever. So I think there's many great opportunities, and not least many high-ranking universities also, like Uppsala you mentioned, for example, is really a good ranking university worldwide there. So it's a lot to offer.
And not a lot of people think, oh, the Nordic countries are very, very cold. Well, that's quite an interesting thing because, outside it might be cold during winter, but inside it's quite hot. We got heating in the Nordic countries. So inside it's hot, outside it's cold during the winters. But the summers are amazing in Sweden. Like we've got long days, we're talking about like in the northern part of Sweden, it gets dark. Yeah, it doesn't even get dark. Like you got 24 hours of sun for about 5 weeks, actually quite interesting. While in the winter time, it's a bit different, I would say. But it's a time to go for a fika in Sweden, where you go pretty much, what is a fika? Yeah, you got coffee and some pastries with your friends. That is a Swedish fika. So it's a time to drink a lot of coffee during winter, I would say. We can help you. I'm a little bit afraid that we got a reply, but we do not work with any universities in Umeå, I'm afraid. So I can't help you. We specialize on some universities. We've been trained on selling some universities. We represent some universities in Sweden, but I'm afraid we do not represent any universities in Umeå. I'm really sorry about that, Ines. And I would like to share, and now like I would like to share you a video about studying in the Nordics. One second, I'm going to stop sharing it. Then I'm going to share the screen with you about studying in Sweden. Second, and I will share it with you. Here I got it. This was quite an interesting video about studying in Sweden. I could see during my presentation, there are a lot of opportunities, as Johan said, scholarship covers pretty much of everything. And to study in Finland, to apply to study in Finland doesn't cost anything. Study in Sweden, about 90 euros. And please contact us as soon as possible. We'd like to study in the Nordic countries because quite a few papers you need. It's not that much, actually. You need to translate your transcripts, your official diploma from a bachelor degree, and that's about it. But still, I think it's very important to have a look at the preparation with IELTS exam to get a good score on that one. It might take some time. Johan, we did it quite fast. We're going to have another presentation about studying Nordics this autumn, in August or September. That's for first presentation now, we come up another one a little bit later on this year. Johan, I'm not sure if you'd like to say something to the ones who are here with us today. Ines is one of those, but it's the, as I said, like this webinar is getting recorded. Any last words from you, Johan?
Yes, if someone wants to get help from help to study in Scandinavia or somewhere else in the world, step one is usually to fill out the information request at DreamStudiesAbroad.com, and then we can put you in touch with Jürgen, Instituto Nordico, if they have the suitable schools. And if you want to study somewhere else in the world, well, then we can help you to find a partner who can help you apply there. And of course, you can always enjoy the free information we have here. And we're really looking forward to welcoming you in Scandinavia or wherever you want to study abroad.
Thanks to that, Johan, for having us here with us today. And as Johan said, contact Johan, he will forward the contact details to us. Thanks a lot, Johan. Have a great evening. For us, it's a bit of about lunchtime here.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Okay.
Here in Sweden, okay. Where in the evening. Thank you, Jürgen.
Okay, bye.
Bye.